My battery's low. Come on. Just about to do this.
My battery just like ran out like mid while I was just about to start recording. That's why I bought extras from Amazon, so I can keep the content going for you guys. Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to Just JP. My name is Justin. Thank you for joining me here. Thank you for clicking the video. If it's your first time, don't make it last. If it's not your first time, welcome back. So typically, just so that you guys know, typically what I'll do to get song requests is I'll literally just go through the comments. If I see one that's been kind of brought up a lot, I'll put those in basically a notepad in my phone, and I'll just kind of work my way through them as I can. But while I'm recording and while I'm doing a session, honestly, sometimes I'll just open up the app, just like look at most recent ones and just kind of choose one randomly that may just catch my attention. So today we are doing a viewer's request by Joe Pick. He said, "Is there any way you could do Marathon by Rush? Would love to see your reaction and see what you think." Thanks, Joe Pick. Joe, I got you. You caught me. It just happened to be I'm recording, so I literally saw it and I'm already here. Why not? Marathon, as far as I know, is not a song that's ever been requested on the channel, and I know there's been a lot of other Rush songs that have been requested ahead of this. Don't worry, guys. There's time. There's time for everything. I'm gonna work towards them. I just happened to see this one and I figured why not. So, super quick question, and these videos are recorded a little bit ahead of time. This particular one is like only like 4 days ahead of time. It's not like that far from when I'm actually recording. But I'll ask questions on Twitter, and because I don't have 1,000 subscribers yet, I can't ask questions like a general question on YouTube. So I'm relying on the videos for now. Get me to 1,000, then we can talk a little bit more. But I have a quick question for you guys. I release my videos every day at midnight. Do you guys like that they are released at midnight Eastern time, or would you prefer that they're released at a different time? See, I do midnight just because honestly, it's just simple, I guess. Like the next day, like immediately they're available. You can kind of watch it whenever you want to, whether it's after you come home from work at 5 o'clock, or if you happen to stay up late in from the day before and you just happen to be up while it's uploaded, it's there for you. It's consistency. One way or another, it would be consistent. I'm just curious, do you guys like that time, or would you prefer them release at a different time? Honestly, like, give me your opinions. I'm open. It literally does not affect me at all to just change the dial a little bit. I don't honestly want your guys' opinions. You guys have a big part of this channel, so it's up to you. Joe, thank you again for the recommendation and for joining me here on Just JP, as well as all the rest of you. Of course, you can join me on Twitter. Please, please, please let me know what you guys think of the song, as it's your opinions that matter, and I love hearing back from you guys, obviously. This is the song Marathon by Rush. Okay, before I get into it, for you Rush fans, because I always throw the ball in your court. Why did I say that like I was from like New Jersey, the bowl? I always throw it in your court. Where does this song rank on your list of Rush songs? Is this generally considered a good Rush song? Is this generally considered a bad Rush song? Rush song. Is it generally one that's kind of forgotten? I honestly want to hear your thoughts before I give mine. So pause the video, write your comment. Okay. So from what I understand of Rush, they started more progressive. For example, their album 2112. It was very progressive. From what I understand, I may be wrong. And as the years went on, they kind of became a little more straightforward. I think this song honestly is great. I think this song was awesome. I love this song. I think it's a very straightforward song, but and honestly, even though it's a 6-minute song, I don't consider it really progressive. It's very straightforward in the way that it plays, but I really love every single element of this song. Okay, from the very beginning, you got this nice setup, this nice build up. Kind of sounds like a marathon with what they're going for in the lyrics and the story, like a race. That bass line that it sets up right there, I love that so much. I love the way it leads in to the song from that buildup. I don't know the technical name for it because I never got that far in bass playing, but I love the rolls, basically, like the quick playing, like the spurts. I love that. It adds so much character and flavor to the song. And he's not playing fast just to play fast. Like, it just works. I really enjoy that a lot. And I like the tone, whether that's the pedal or whatever, that he uses on the bass, because it has that wonky wah-wah-wah-wah-wah-wah-wah-wah sound, but it's not cheesy. It doesn't sound weird. Honestly, it sounds really good. It works very well. And then one thing I really like about the verse itself, I love when verses change within the verse itself. So whether that be the pacing, the tempo, instrument drop-ins or instruments coming in, I love when they change mid-verse. So Rush does the same thing here. I love that. It's a very simple thing, but I love when bands do that in their verses. It adds so much more character to the song. It makes it so much more interesting and fun to listen to, honestly. Like, it makes me want to listen to it more. And it's not that they're changing that verse up just to stay interesting. They're doing it because it's fun and it works and it just sounds good. I think I've said it before and I think a lot of you will agree with me. The standout is the bass. I think Geddy Lee is an awesome bassist. First of all, incredible that he plays the bass and sings as well as he does. I just think that's an awesome talent, one in itself. But the way he does it is so effortless. It takes a lot, a lot of talent to do that. Another part that I really enjoyed, honestly, is the guitar solo and the guitar break near the end of the song. So I like that the bass at this point in the song kind of takes a back seat and lets the guitar go and just like do this nice little solo. And it really does sound good. It's nice, it's fast paced, and I love the ending of it, which we'll get to in a second. But from the busy, not in a bad way, but in a good way, from the busy bass line that it was putting down before and really leading the song, at this point it takes a back seat and just provides this nice drifting note for the guitar to do its work and its job, and it sounds great. And I love this. This is perfect. Love that. That's good. I think of a lot of you by now know that I like slow and powerful moments, and the way that they transition from a guitar solo that I was already really enjoying right back into that slowed down, dropping out the heavy bass and everything like that, just very powerful, intimate moment in the musicianship. I just feel like that's very, very well done. I love how it sounds. I think the transition is great. I think the flow of the whole song is amazing. So the song kind of seems to be, I mean, kind of literally talking about a marathon or a race. And I like the way that he's explaining, basically, it's not how fast you go, it's how long you can endure. He's using this in a literal sense throughout the writing process, but obviously this can apply to many things. In most cases, a marathon is applied to life. It's not how fast you go, it's how you endure the pain of it, right? So he says in the very first verse, it's not how fast you can go, the force goes into the flow. If you pick up the beat, you can forget about the heat. So if you can kind of get into the rhythm of life, as I'm going to take it here, then you can get through the pain of it if you can kind of get into the rhythm of life and get into a flow, basically. More than just survival, more than just a flash, more than just a dotted line, more than just a dash. It's not about trying to get from point A to point B as quickly as you can. It's not about like some sort of survival, you know, it's not about the end goal. It's about the journey and what you kind of do during it. Your meters may overload. You can rest at the side of the road. You can miss a stride, but nobody gets a free ride. So even if something happens, maybe tragically in your life, you can take a break. It's okay to slow down. But don't think that that's going to get you anywhere. You still need to keep up. I think the whole song honestly is summed up in this one line near the end. You can make the most of the distance. The distance in life, honestly, it can be a long thing, and it should be a long thing, a certain expected length. But sometimes that distance, unfortunately, by tragic events or whatever, can be a little shorter than others. But it's not necessarily about the ending. It's not about that. It's about the journey. It's about what you do in your life. It's about how you endure, how you take the pains, the struggles, and how you work to go past them, to overcome them, to become better in some way or another. There's nothing wrong with taking a break. There's nothing wrong with resting on the side of the road, as it says. But don't give up. Keep moving. Complete your journey. Don't focus on the end. Focus on the road ahead. This is great. I would listen to it. I think this is a great song. Once again, I want to know your opinions on it. But just looking at Wikipedia and kind of getting a little bit of other information, Power Windows is the 11th studio album by Rush. Where does this album rank on Rush's discography? Because it's the 11th one, they have a lot of albums. Where does this one sit? Is it on the higher end, on the lower end? Is it kind of in the middle? Does it have a few good songs and maybe not so much? I don't know. Let me know what you guys thought of the song. Let me know what you think of literally everything. If you want to talk to me, just call me out. I'm always down in the comment section. By the way, you can join me there in the comment section. You can join me on Twitter. Joe Pick, thank you so much for the recommendation. I really do appreciate it. And I hope you guys have a great rest of the day, afternoon, night, whichever it may be. I'll see you guys later.